Hello, XCMS Online now provides a systems biology platform that allows to directly map raw metabolomics data onto biological pathways and subsequently perform multiomic integration using transcriptomic and proteomic data. This video is made up of two parts, pathway analysis and multiomic integration. My name is Tao Huan. I'll give a demonstration of the first part, and my colleague, Dr. Eric Forsberg, will focus on the second part. Our systems biology analysis begins with a predictive pathway analysis that predicts dysregulated metabolic pathways directly from the accurate mass values of the features generated from the XCMS processed results. Several parameters need to be properly defined in the parameter settings for its reliable performance. This includes the correct biological species, mass tolerance for the M over Z matching in pathway analysis, intensity threshold to exclude low abundance peaks from the analysis, and a p-value cutoff to extract the statistically significant metabolic features for the predictive pathway analysis. Once all the parameters are properly set, predictive pathway analysis will be conducted automatically after the metabolomic data process in XCMS Online. You can interpret the pathway analysis results by clicking the Systems Biology results located at the lower left screen inside the job summary page. This Systems Biology results tabulates all the predicted pathways together with the involved genes, proteins, metabolites, and pathway p-values. Each item in the table links to additional internal or external resources if you need more information. For instance, click the number of overlapping putative metabolites opens a page of detailed information about the involved dysregulated metabolites. Click the feature detail open another window that displays the LC chromatogram, MS spectrum, and the box and the whisker plot of that metabolic feature. We also provide a simple visualization tool called Pathway Cloud Plot. It can be accessed from either job summary page underneath the systems biology results or the up left blue button inside the systems biology results. In the Pathway Cloud Plot, the percentage of overlap metabolites is on the x-axis and the negative log p-value is on the y-axis. Each metabolic pathway is represented as a circle in the plot. The radius of each circle represents the relative number of metabolites observed for a given pathway. The interactive pathway cloud plot allows users to zoom in on any part of the plot by drawing a rectangle with a cursor. Users can reset to original plot by clicking on Reset Zoom box in top right of the graph. Adjust the p-value threshold on the left side of the pathway cloud plot to refine display pathways with the p-value smaller than that threshold. Adjust the bubble radius for better plot visualization by turning the bar on the top right side of the plot. Place cursor over the circle to generate a pop-up. Click on the circle to display a brief pathway results table in which additional information can be accessed through the hyperlinks. In addition, the entire list of dysregulated metabolic features can be accessed by clicking the predictive metabolites results inside the systems biology results. Click the name of pathway involved links to a list of all the overlapping dysregulated metabolites in that pathway. User can also type in the metabolite name in the search bar on the top right of the page to get information for a particular metabolite. The pathway analysis results can also be downloaded via the Download Results button on the top right of the Job Results Summary page. In the downloaded folder, the pathway analysis results are located under Results, MummyCheck, TSV.
Hello, my name is Erica Forsberg, and I'm going to talk to you about how to perform multiomic integration on XCMS Online. Press the plus button beside Multiomics Data to open the Systems Biology Matching Parameters window to manage the subjob for omics integration. Click Upload List to open the uploader window. After selecting or dragging and dropping the file, wait for the upload to complete. Click Save and Proceed to close the window. If another file is to be uploaded, repeat this process as only one omics file may be uploaded at a time. On the main window, select whether the file is a gene or protein list from the drop-down box. If the file type is a protein list, ensure the correct accession ID format is also selected. Once all the parameters have been confirmed, click Run Matching Subjob. The progress bar will show 100% when the job is complete. The multi-omic integration results can be seen by clicking View Results to see the matching genes or proteins and their pathway involvement. A run log is also available after the job is finished to check for completion statistics or error messages. Once the job is complete, this window can be closed. This data is available for review at any time by pressing the plus button again. If future jobs on newly acquired omics data needs to be run, this process can be repeated by uploading additional files and running another subjob. To view differentially expressed genes and proteins that are overlapping with the predicted dysregulated pathways, click the Systems Biology Results button. Genes and proteins matching with the dysregulated pathways will now be tabulated in the results table. The overlap list can be downloaded in TSV or PDF format at the top of the table. Clicking on the overlapping gene number in a pathway will open a new window showing the percentage of overlapping genes within that pathway and a detailed list of the overlapped genes. Clicking on the gene name will link to the BioPsych page containing the gene information. Clicking on the enzyme commission number will open a page describing the enzymatic reaction for the encoded protein related to that gene. In a similar fashion to gene overlap, clicking the overlapping protein number shows the percentage of overlapping proteins in a pathway and a detailed list of the overlapped proteins. Clicking on the proteins in the list links to the BioPsych page that shows related protein information. The protein identifier that was used to perform the subjob will be populated in the table. In this case, gene ID was used, so the table is populated under that heading, while the UniProt ID will show as NA or not available. Clicking on the accession ID links to the UniProt protein information and the genes that encode for it. Clicking on the pathways involved opens a list of pathways that protein is involved in. Each pathway in that list opens a BioPsych page with metabolic pathway information. Overall, a modestly experienced user should be able to execute the data interpretation in our systems biology platform in about 30 to 40 minutes. Thank you for using XCMS Online. Feel free to contact us if you have any questions.